matches must go ahead.
Definitely. As far as I know, somebody of the Australians killed his PC with a glass of water, so...
Oh my god.
Thus the delay. Yeah.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Good luck.
Alright, here we go. We'll check out the teams as they come from the Sunderers.
Following Bucks.
The back side, they're going 4 heavies, 1 LA, and 1 bolter. Would imagine it's the same on the VS side. No, in fact, they have 2 bolters. And
so
4 heavies.
So both Nakasi and Inflames bolting.
I would imagine so.
Now, I wonder how well that's going to work out.
Well, if you're confident in the ability of your bolters, it could be a good play to go for. In fact, they have a lot of assault as well, so they must only have 3 heavy assaults. So we'll see how that works out for them. Some nice shiny camos there on behalf of the Bax team. Lots of yellow. There's no quit in a TR
soldier. The perks of having your own accounts on Jaeger.
Yeah.
More swag on your players.
Laser with his bright purple camo. Front and center.
Cross you on point for Bax.
Yeah, slow start to this match. Both teams kind of feeling each other out. Not wanting to be over-aggressive.
It's interesting because I've heard that supposedly the Bax team is supposed to be passive, but like I'm not seeing the Bricks team being hugely aggressive either in this opener.
Double kill off legacy on point.
Two heavies pushing one under the roof here for joke. See if they get pincered now in a second. Following this infiltrator onto the roof, jumps down onto balcony. And there's a 3v1 going down here. Two kills to the Bax guys and only one for... Sorry, two kills on the Bax guys and only one in return. Point control is neutral right now. Got a heavy on the point for... Both sides right now. Laser playing on the balcony. Light assault going down there for Bax.
Once again, control the Bricks.
Point. Laser goes down around the corner there to an anchor. 16 points apiece at this stage.
And we've got a nice flank going for the Bax team. 3 heavies going onto the Bricks balcony.
Right.
And getting ready to push into their building.
Got
now let's see
out.
How this will go.
Alright, here they go.
Going in, and I'm seeing...
Being careful here as they get one pick, I believe. Oh, Conk got that guy pretty good, actually. Surprised that they're not running Conk grenades in this format. Sorry, Conk prevention in this format. As there usually are 3 or 4 players with ability to Conk, but only one possibility for an EMP grenade. Right,
laser takes down Honkwa on their own ledge.
Only one kill separating the teams currently.
Although, I guess the flank did not work out as well as it could have. Like, it got them the point back, but still, it didn't push them far ahead in the scoring.
Yeah, avoiding the point right now, actually. As 3 players take down the light assault. Point only now flipping to the VS.
Again, triple flank on Balcony for Backstroke.
Yeah, spotted out, though, by one of the heavies. On the point, the joke heavy takes out the guy camping in the pocket, but there is one more guy remaining on point. Legacy. About to get 2v1 here though. Gets one kill. And goes down without being able to commissioner the second. Some action inside the building here for the Bax players are pushed into the joke building, shooting through the corners almost at the zip trigger. Nice knife kill there from Skimp, taking down the zip trigger. Some conks coming out. Check the roof, see how things are going. The fearsome sound of a GD7.
It's a vehicle threat, and afterwards she pulls down.
Nice kill there from from a disadvantage for that heavy assault, getting two there before he goes down. Rook, I think it was. Joke leading by 16 points right now with point control. One player playing very aggressively here, hiding up in the rocks. Let's see how he does. If someone pushes past him, it could be to their doom.
So I reckon in this match the point control and point flips might actually make or break it, since, well, I was about to say the frags are sort of equal, but apparently Joke is sort of going ahead, slowly but steadily.
18 points. Nice flank there from the heavy was behind, but he gets bolted from the infiltrator. Two players peeking here, want to be careful they don't shoot each other. Low health, heavy backs off to reload. Take a look downstairs and see what Joker up to.
And 1 minute to go in the cup, less than that.
Right. We'll follow Laser then as he attempts to push back in. Trade there in the corner. Heavy goes down. Exchange for a heavy on the backs team.
And again, double flank on balcony for backs.
Seems to be their favorite strategy at the moment, but
Laser
it appears to be working
point.
Out.
Yeah, they use it against us on the screen.
Cross John attempts to push, but is forced off by Legacy in the opposite corner. Joke leading by 14 points at this stage in the map. 12 points now. As Laser claims back too. There's an aggressive push into the building. We'll follow him here. Gets caught by a lot of salt. Still sprinting and goes down. Another heavy pushing in though. We'll check out him.
And interestingly enough, the Australian Bolter is pushing into their building as well, but he goes down to the light assault as well.
Here's the
so that guy gets 2v1.
Characteristic aggression of the Briggs players. Costing him there as he goes down in 1v1. Follow Skimp then as he attempts to push back in with his football camo. On the roof as he crosses over to the enemy balcony. Point is back to the 50-50 mark, being neutralized by the NC. Skim pushing into the enemy building here. Downstairs, but finds three players.
Managed to escape though.
He's quick to run away though, yeah.
Yeah, he has support from balcony as well.
Two
as well as one heavy pushing on the ground floor as well for backs.
Against the entire Australian team here. 4v2. Backs make it out with one kill. A lot of salt. Intelligently running away from the roof rather than fighting five players.
Although this strategy seems to be really working out well for backs since they're slowly increasing their lead to 14 points now again at this point.
Yeah, I think key in this half will be whoever manages to get the point, if someone does it all.
Yeah. At this point, we have 7 minutes left, so it really could go either way.
Could go one way and then get a recap, even. Yeah. Laser leading his team.
This I like to
point.
See.
Three players there. Three heavies, in fact.
And one of the Briggs players gets caught off guard as he tries to flank.
Naz gets a kill there on the roof.
On
the balcony. On silos. Two backs players have dropped down on the point. A lot of salt and a heavy. Three players now, in fact. Follow the light assault and see if he can take out some people inside. Yeah, Juan Quao, easy kill there for him on the bolter at close range.
Oh, he didn't die.
There's three backs heavies in the building of the Australians right now.
Got one guy playing,
controlling it heavily.
Cross John playing a pretty safe spot back here on the top of his building, suppressing the players, want for a better word, as they push across.
One of the backs
now,
goes down.
Laser was going for the roof, but gets bolted by the backs bolter.
Right. See quite
that's
a few dead heavies here. Nice turnaround there from A-Flick. One of the strongest
yeah,
players
that,
on,
that
on
was
the roster.
Definitely.
Pretty sweet kill.
When we screened them, I found A-Flick to be probably their strongest player.
some nice angles here. Almost the whole team getting massacred in the same spot by only two players. Light assault does go down, but overall it's positive points trade for for Joe, which is what they're looking for at this point, is they have a slight lead and likely to get a point.
Well, you
here.
Say slight, but they are leading by 28 points right now.
I didn't even notice that, yeah. It's more significant than I anticipated. With 4 seconds
and
left on the
most
point.
Most likely, yeah, they're going to definitely get that now as well and increase their lead.
There we go, point cap for the Blaguettes.
So, including the cap, it's now 76 to 124 for Blaguettes.
It is indeed.
Which is quite a significant lead for, like, equally matched team.
Considering this is, I don't know, a kind of a grudge match, I guess, from Dirtledome, where it was a pretty close map, down to the wire, only separated by a few points. I wonder how the second half will go. Maybe the Briggs guys are still half asleep and they'll warm up in the second half.
Well, that's a good point. I believe they have actually just called some backup on their team and literally got him out of bed by phone call to play.
Oh god.
Since one of their guys killed the PC, I said early. But still, the backs contestion of the Australians building is still pretty strong.
Yeah, we'll go and check that out. One. There, attempted to win a 2v1, but unable to do so. Watching out pretty aggressively there. Another player pushes in and takes down a light assault.
And Huangkao takes down the bolter on the roof.
Yeah.
Good job from Huangkao. He's putting a lot of pressure on those LAs.
He's a pretty well-known player on Emerald, known to be a lag wizard, so he's just right at home here. Knows exactly what's going on with Ping and how to exploit it. As it's taken. Nice there from Dirtle, actually. Shooting the Water Assault out of midair with a headshot and a knife. Laser going for a flank, we'll check him out.
Speaking of flanks, there's currently Aethlyk again pushing far around the Australian building and coming in from behind them.
Skimp being aggressive and getting caught out, I think, in a 3v1 crossfire.
Yeah, definitely nice play from Laser right there.
Aethlyk,
and he gets
the bolter.
Laser with a triple kill.
One for one trade there on the staircase.
Yeah, although he got 2 kills in that life, so back still increasing their lead.
I think Laser brought it back there, getting 2 or 3 kills as he pushed into the opposing building. Get spotted though, you'll likely have to run away. Oh, nice kill there from the infiltrator. Hal had some help, but he managed to get off 2 commie shots. With 2 minutes and 30 seconds, there is no time for a recap for the Bax team, unfortunately. So it'll come down to frags for the remainder of this half. With about, right about 50 points separating the teams. Maybe one kill there for Unicorn downstairs.
Just keep pushing Briggs Valkyrie. And taking that one.
Bolt goes down to pick him off, but takes damage and is forced to run away. Heavy chase but gets taken out with a lot of salt as the Bolt goes down on the roof. Point control regained by Unicorn as he takes out Laser. Holding the light assault inside right now. Eyes open, enemy heavy. 3 players here on the lower floor with Alfalo fallen now as he attempts to go for a flank.
Interestingly, going for a flank on the ground while being the light assault.
Well, there's not really much reason to be flying at this point. He wants to stay hidden from the bolter as he gets into a position to push.
Fair point, but there's currently
heavy coming his way.
Oh, but they're not seeing him.
Man, they know he's there
but
now.
But he gave himself.
Probably the end for him.
Yeah.
As he goes down to the heavy. Laser
he
on the roof.
Should not have given himself
there. Crossfire.
Not have given himself away there.
I think he heard the heavies jumping up, and he knew he was surrounded there. Aethlyk and Crossjam both going down. Seconds left on this recap. 40 seconds left in the match. With 48 points currently separating the teams as we go into the halftime break. two heavies here pushing. A nice flank there from the light assault, combined with the clutch commissioner play. Turns that around.
Well, correct me if I'm wrong, but the northern side is considered to be slightly stronger, is it not?
It is indeed, due to the easier access to your own building, I guess.
Yeah, so I'm really curious to see if the Bricks team will manage to turn that around in the second half.
6-5-4
as the half
three
ends now.
2-1 halftime.
With a 45-point lead for Bax Joke, Baguettes, however you want to call them.
Alright, looking at the halftime scores then, it appears just, you know, solid performance. Everyone pretty much a couple of points positive here on the Bax Joke roster. Nobody standing out in particular, but nobody being particularly negative either. On the Briggs roster, it is fairly similar. People just going slightly negative, but in flames, dragging his team down at the moment, unable to really claw together a comprehensive 1v1 victories, it seems.
Yeah. Also, if looking at by the stats, we're watching right now a low kill game compared to the previous game, for example, we played or any of the others. Not many kills on the first half compared to the previous games.
Yeah, I guess it's really down to the teams having lots of respect for one another, despite the sort of banter and rivalry going on between them from Dirtledome. It's really, if you know you're facing a strong team, you're going to play a bit more reserved, probably, and feel out what the other team's going for. So I'm curious to see if there's going to more fracks happen in the second half. Also, as Briggs probably warms up a bit more.
Yeah. It's funny, when Laser claims his team is very aggressive, it didn't really see that much of the aggression here. None of the no aggressive, like, 3 or 4 man pushes. Well, there was one, but there were one point in the match where they pushed aggressively into the opposing building. But I guess when you're down in kills and don't have the point control, it's hard to pull off that aggression.
Yeah, but I think it also goes in line with something I was about to say, which is that maybe the double bolter approach is not working.
I think they switched away from that, I think, pretty quickly, no?
Oh, yes,
really?
They did.
I thought they kept them.
After the first wipe, they switched away and only Naz remained as a bolter.
No, but they may be caught off guard a bit by Joke being a bit... Joke backs, whatever. Being a bit more aggressive than they anticipated. Because I've heard the Australians claim that this American team is rather passive, which they clearly were not in this half.
Well, I
in
think
fact,
it,
they
it was
were probably more aggressive than the Australians.
In Laser's defense, it was a very different team he played against. When he played against them, it was more so a Joke plus Mix team. So it was Joke. Sorry, no, Bax plus Mix. It was Iris from DA, and it was E-Dubs and a couple of Bax guys, whereas here it's Bax and Joke making up a team. So it's not quite the same one as that you played against them. So playstyles differ, I guess. Alright, so we got about 2 minutes then until the second half kicks off. Got some shit talking in chat. Lex and Cheese talking shit to E-Dubs about gameplay and in their matches on Pale Canyon. So, Dwayner, any thoughts on what Laser and Co. can do in the second half to bridge the deficit?
Definitely, they need to get the initial cup and get an aggressive hold on the opposite building ASAP. I would say you need to lock them down, just get some kills, some farm. Try to use your bolter, like Narcasse from the other roof, to spot the opposite players coming down the Sandy. Pretty much, I would say that's the go-to. We've seen Briggs All-Stars climb back some games. We saw them beat AC team on Dirtledome, and they were pretty far behind on the second half, So I think there is room for them to claw back their way in this game.
Oh, definitely. Oh. And I'm much expecting the Bricks team to play quite a bit more aggressive now, since they have the slightly stronger side, with probably a bit more convenient access to the enemy balcony as well, since from the northern side you have a bit more cover as you try to flank on there.
Yeah.
Alright, we'll be kicking out the second half now in a minute's time. But I think, Johannes, that Bax at least would, from casting with Dirtle previously, that he prefers the southern side of the base. So if they were able to do better on what they perceive is the weaker side, now I'd love to see how they do on what they claim is better.
Yeah, that's interesting. Did he say why he prefers that particular side?
Yeah, he likes the extra access to the roof, I believe. Like, it's much harder to get shut out of your own building.
That's a good point. If you go over the rock onto the roof on the southern half, you can actually intersect flanks from the north to the balcony quite well as well.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Yeah, so we have
uninstalling.
A little mistake there from our referee pronoun. Forgets to make sure the point is neutralized.
Well.
Got some complaints from the Bax team that they're missing precious drinking time.
Well, it is a good point. After all, well, it is Saturday.
Also, I notice Inflames is gonna be bolting now.
All right, so gonna start off with a double again, I guess.
I don't think so. I think I only saw one. I think Narcassa is gonna be playing heavy.
All right.
I don't think the double bolt strategy really is a wise thing to do.
Although some people in Europe thought different when we published the threats for the
tournament. Well, yes, yeah. But it's clearly not gonna work out. Like, this format is pretty well established at this point, although not in Europe so much. But rarely we've seen double bolts or like multiple bolts be like
effective.
Yeah, it's more a gimmick than anything else, really. As the like in these type of formats, the bolt really isn't the top fragger. He might get some picks, but he's like mostly there for spotting and denying some
area denial. Yeah,
some areas, getting the enemy team to be a bit paranoid about getting their face shot in. So, now with the base actually ready, we might actually see a second half now.
Yeah, just waiting for it to be set up again, I think. They incorrectly set it to being VS, but I'll leave that up to Pranam. He's the expert in these matters, not me.
Well, to be fair, it should be fine with how it's set up, since our scoring script doesn't actually track the caps at all anyway.
Yeah, I guess. But
so we just add them on manually.
Yeah. All right. We'll see. 13
seconds. Let's try this again. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
All right, here we go with the second half then. With the
and the Bricks team indeed has two bolters.
Yes, right. I just checked. Both Inflames and Narcassa bolting.
Right, we see four heavies, so no light assault then after the start of this half. Interesting to see if Fallen switches over at any point. But early flank here for the light assault. Gets one heavy down and manages to get around the corner before going down. It's a bit of a theme while facing Australians.
Double flank from Bax again. coming from the east door.
Yeah, this game gets one bullet, which is in
very aggressive,
three players
getting...
in. One bolter caught out. Gets a nice EMP and gets two kills, in fact, between the two bolters.
Yes.
Clearing up that push pretty nice, though.
Well, that
but
does
big play from that bolter. Big play.
That was a, I think overall that was a 3v3 in terms of kills. But
but Joke stayed alive behind that box.
Joke do have the point, however, up by 30 points in kills plus the 24 in the base cap, so it's a 50 point differential to be made up.
Rick's also at some point now.
Alright, equalizing that.
Skimp again, going for east door flank, followed by who I think is iFlick.
It is indeed. Skimp gets caught out though, and the repeat from iFlick forces the two heavies into cover. Bit of a Mexican standoff now, as neither team can really afford to make the peak.
Yeah, and there's four people inside the Australians building, but there's flank going on from the light assault apparently, who's downstairs in the Australians building, but gets taken down by a heavy. Sitting on a weird ledge.
Though takes that opportunity to push in, clears up two heavies there, I think, on the ground floor. Laser pushing back into his own building now. Two players outside. Aflick hiding in the corner, we'll see how he does. Goes down to 3-1 there, unfortunately.
Yeah. Not much you can really do there.
Laser and Legacy going for balcony flank, maybe? No. They think better about it, they just go around and get in their building.
Yeah, I think they need to focus on getting a point cap back to narrow the deficit down. Should be key for them right now. Secure the base cap and then worry about farming people.
And currently, the NC Bolter is facing off in a 2v1 against both VS Bolters on the roof. Not getting taken down, really.
Good luck to him in that, then.
Yeah. Although, he appears to have a slightly harder time now.
Legacy sitting on top of the smokestack. Flanking coming once more from Skin.
But he's gonna get taken down.
Aflick going down there to Fallen. Switched away from his light assault. On Cry engaging a bit of movement meta as he's getting bolted. Goes down.
But goes down as well. Yeah, it seems the Australians have adapted to the more aggressive Backs Joke team now.
They're letting them run in. One kill down without the cap.
So if they actually manage to get that cap through, it's gonna be all open again.
They are down by 18 points, actually, disregarding the capture. So there's still a margin for them to make up at this point.
And Backs trying the three-man flank downstairs again.
One for one so far as Juan Cryo pushes in also. Attempts to take out a bolter and gets double peeked by heavies and taken down instantly.
Meanwhile, Aflake and Skimp are still outside the Australians building, waiting for their shields and to push back in. Going into the building, getting one frag. Getting M though by the bolter again. Same spot as last time.
Will there come a point where they decide that flank isn't worth it? Hasn't really played out for them so far this match at all.
Unicorn taken down.
Now they did get the point back though, but the Australians hard on it already again. And laser going for the flank downstairs.
Getting out a whole magazine there, but unable to get a kill as he gets gets the kill right as he gets flanked by Juan Cryo. Getting the mag shot, mag cutter kill. Enemy heavy spotted. Want to see some mag shot action though, I have to say. A mag scatter, my apologies. The shotgun pistol would be interesting to see some of that. It's like under 10 meters, it's like a commissioner, but you can't miss. Legacy going for a flank again, being 2v1 down by Aflick and Skimp.
They are being on the same flank again, but there's two Australians inside, pushing out now,
getting them both
and
down.
Managing to take them both out, I'm not sure they should really use that flank anytime soon anymore. Like, they really should switch up their tactics a bit.
Yeah, I think at this point it's somewhat predictable. Although the points do tell a different story. They're not really losing any points.
No, but they're steadily losing the base cap, which is gonna make this an equal playground.
That'd be still a 16-point differential, even if they do get the cap. Ah, Blitz coming out, but Crossjohn still trades. Is that our first SMG so far?
Double flank from Drake's team. Get one kill on the south building ground floor.
Alright. Dirt all attempting to roll off his heavy.
Yeah.
Inflames gets downed by Dirtle, but then kill returned by Inflames.
Meanwhile, Aflick is in the Australians building, harassing them and getting a frag or two.
So on the back. Trades out with laser, but gets killed. Crossjohn cleaning that up then with his SMG. Nice repeat there from Huanquao. Fooling the heavy into thinking he was running away.
Yeah, that was really well played, actually.
Yeah, out of all the players on that backs team, he is the one who knows how to abuse the client side. As it's his natural environment. Getting chased here by a heavy, Legacy. Getting bolted as he goes for him. Attempting to run away. GD7F is too strong.
And Huanquao makes it out of the balcony.
Yeah, it's interesting. We as BHRT have played against the Bax Joke team before, and I didn't think Huanquao was that good. At least in that match, he didn't do as well. Maybe the Briggs team is getting let down by their light assault a bit, in that sense.
Don't they have one at the moment? That's the thing.
Actually, yeah, that's a good point.
They went for the double bolter. The double bolter play, which involved going for four heavies to maintain that pushing power.
So, oh my god, Aflix just got a DRT flank.
Only gets one kill though, but it does force the entire team back.
He got shot in the head, I think, by the bolter, so he had to back off.
You can see here, the disadvantage that you get though from playing on this building. It's much, much harder to get back in when you get pushed out of it. You're forced to use
definitely.
The slow wall climb.
And this sort of bold claim has gotten the point cap slightly in favor of Bax again.
Trade
which might be the one thing that secures them a victory.
I think if they were to get another base cap, it would probably put the match out of range of Briggs.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Down by 30 kills and 48 from two base caps would be a pretty hard ask.
I might even go so far to say that Bax is probably going to win at this point, because it's getting closer and closer with 6 and a bit minutes left on the clock for the cap, which is still 2 minutes away, which is a considerable time.
Many Orions firing at a phase with each other. Nice shot there from Naz. A lot of salt. Yeah, that 10,000 RPM Orion going off downstairs. Flank control. There's 6 minutes approximately left in the match, but so either team could still get a cap, but the possibility for a recap is not there at this point.
Now,
not too far for that.
Looking at the team rosters, both teams do not actually have their strongest team they could field on the field right now, if I'm not mistaken.
Who's missing over on the back side?
Do they not have
two players, Aflick and Skimp, and Skirt going for this push? Aflick makes quick work of that player, hiding in the corner as he pushes back.
Did Bax not have Therum on their roster as well, or was that on?
That was on Hood.
No, he's on Hood.
Oh, yeah.
Bolter goes down there, Dirtle going down to a push from Legacy. Enemy heavy. Can he force the way though from the heavies on the rocks? Aggression here from the Bolter, actually, for... I think that's a... in flames, pushing out before they even have point control. Getting a kill there inside his own building, cleaning it up. Taking down Aflick. Was caught with a commissioner out.
Though Aflick is really putting some work down, currently being the top fragger for the Americans with 28 kills so far. And a pretty decent 14 net score.
Yeah. It's Durvok topping the net score, though, getting some nice picks.
He just goes down.
Just under 4 minutes now remaining in the match then. Nice shot there from Naz on Juan Crow as he crossed. Or in flames, in fact. Skimp making it just out of light before getting down by in flames.
Crossion and Unicorn pushing the opposite building team a bit.
Unicorn goes building. Down, Laser gets a commie kill on Aflick. Or Crossion actually.
Legacy has point control. Bricks,
yeah,
I'll be taking down two.
Two heavies there. Right, a lot of the action now is backs regroup, attempt to push back in.
Yeah. Now, Bricks really needs to get a hold on that point and keep it, since there's 3 minutes 10 seconds left in the match and they still have 2 minutes on the cap. This is probably the only way they will actually still win this, or have a chance of winning that. Even.
Down 22 points in frags alone, and further 24 in the first half base capture. They would need to get 20 kills in this period to make up the difference.
Which is a tall order, seeing how there's not all that many kills in this match still, compared to matches we had before.
To get 10% of their total score already that they already have to equalize it. Crushon has switched away from the side. The blitz come back to his ankle as he drops down. Laser coming down on his head though and taking him out. Another push here on the doorways from Aflick and Skin.
Legacy takes Unicorn down on the point and Breaks keeps it for now.
Right. So at 2 minutes left in the game, there's 1 minute on the point.
And apparently,
their Sunderer has despawned.
Well, that is interesting. You would think you would watch out for that.
We're losing this. Focus out there.
Well, it's our responsibility to make sure people's Sunderers are intact. But I didn't see anyone come along and killing it, so I'd imagine it just despawned.
Yeah, must have done. I'm curious what the ref's call is going to be on this.
Yeah, it's up to Pronam to make a decision. The stream will have a record of what the score was when the match ended, if we want to do something about it. Obviously, some tryhard came along, or some come on bro, and stole the Sunderer. Probably...
No, bro. Briggs getting new Sunday up.
In that time, actually, Bax lost a couple of their points of their lead kills wise to the Sunderless Balls team. Nice shot there from Flames, taking down.
45 seconds left. No possible cap for Briggs. So this should be a win. For Joe comebacks.
Disappointing, yeah, though, that the match ended in a way like that with the Sunderer despawning. Ultimately, even with a cap, probably would have gone in Joke's favor. But it's unfortunate that something like that occurred. Just kind of clouds the result a bit.
Yeah, definitely. Although the Sunderer really shouldn't despawn if people were sat in it at round start. Like, the round is 15 minutes, so...
Well, this is Planet Side, so there are
five,
plenty of bugs.
4, 3, 2, 1.
Alright, guys, that is time up then. We will switch over to the source screen and say goodnight to y'all.
Well, yeah,